Kola Oyeneyin's foresight and grit as one of the pioneers of this growing and important economic and commercial phenomenon has demonstrated the sort of drive that I'm sure many across the room here have, but which is so important in the way that our future as a nation, our future as a commercial community will be defined. I've had an opportunity to collaborate with Kola on several other issues, and I'm extremely pleased to say that he's someone who sees things through. And I've also had an opportunity to collaborate with a few of the entrepreneurs here, especially those who have set up co-working spaces. And I'm very, very happy to say that they are individuals who will ensure that this is not just a flash in the pan, but it continues as the phenomenon that it is. I want to emphasize that this is an economic and social phenomenon. And I say that carefully. The most profound idea of the Industrial Revolution was probably the concept of division of labor. And I'm sure practically all of us are familiar with that concept. The expression was first used by Adam Smith in his classic, The Wealth of Nations. Adam Smith was convinced that the quality and quantity of work carried out by any workforce organized along the principles of division of labor was infinitely superior to work done by non-divided labor. And he said famously, I'll quote him, "The greatest improvement in the productive powers of labor and the greater part of the skill, dexterity, and judgment with which it is anywhere directed, seem to have been the effects of division of labor." End of quote. What Adam Smith was in fact saying was that division of labor was really the greatest phenomenon in the Industrial Revolution, and that it led to the most efficient work. It led to the quantum leap in terms of progress. If division of labor defined the productive genius of the Industrial Revolution, and since then, and since the Industrial Revolution that is, then the very concept of co-working or co-creation must be the defining idea of work, where we work, how we work, in the knowledge economy, and indeed the fourth Industrial Revolution. The point I'm making is that in a period like the 19th and 20th century, division of labor was what defined progress, was what defined that whole revolution. In this age, in the knowledge economy, it is co-working and co-creation that will define the way we work, that will define progress, that will define output. But let us first understand that the deconstruction of the conventional work environment, important as it is the least profound of the implications of co-working. In other words, the mere fact that we're working, sharing working space, as several people are sharing working spaces, that is the least profound of the effects of co-working and co-creation. It is profound, but it's the least profound. The most significant dimension is in the redefinition of how creativity and innovation is birthed. In other words, how do we today, how can we become more creative and innovative? Co-working is what is going to define the new creativity and innovation today. So it's no longer the lone wolf or the outlier. And you know, creativity before now, somebody invented something. Even a couple of years down the road, The likes of Bill Gates were still lone wolves or outliers working from their garages, and same as Mark Zuckerberg, these were still the lone wolf outlier types. But they were working in an environment which was changing very quickly, and which they have also changed very quickly. So we're no longer looking at the age of the lone wolf or the isolated inventor, but collaborative innovation, where ideas are shared and developed and refined collaboratively. So co-creation is also the process by which groups of people from across boundaries come together with a shared purpose to create value through improving or developing services and products. It is by far the game-changing idea of the knowledge economy. It's bound to fundamentally affect how we work. The working spaces will be liberated, not restricted, allowing for flexibility, not just in working hours, but in the modes that we work. But more importantly, it will allow for collaboration, co-innovation, co-value creation. It emphasizes the power in the interdependence and cross-pollination of ideas, not as an inadvertent occurrence, not as an accident, but as a currency, as a way of creating, as a way of marketing, as a way of selling value. We must prepare for the creative disruption of this phenomenon. It will redefine how we teach in our schools, how the student learns, and to some extent, the content of learning in schools. The truth of the matter is that the knowledge economy is bound to change practically everything. Co-working is bound to change everything. It's bound to change how we learn, how we work. Schools before now, the way we taught in our schools before now, was by individual competition. I will be better than the next person in a classroom full of 20. But the classrooms of the future will be classrooms where collaboration is the key, where people will be working together, where young students will be working together to achieve objectives and achieve ideas. And that is already playing out in the way that curricula is defined in various parts of the world today. As a teacher, I am completely fascinated by the new way of thinking. I taught for many years as a law teacher. I recognized that the law teacher would walk into a classroom and talk about the principles of law and discuss the principles of law and hope that the students will learn those principles and at some point apply them. But that's going to change. The law teacher today will have to deal with the concepts of co-creation, even in applied work such as law, such that individuals will be working together to develop solutions to problems, such that teamwork will begin to define the way that the principles themselves will be applied. So rather than a person learning just cramming the principles, just learning the principles and hoping that he'll be able to apply it himself, he's going to be looking at how to deal with concepts such as blockchain technology, for example. How do you work? How do you reason around that? It's no longer linear. Nobody's thinking, nobody can think linear anymore. You cannot think just as an individual. It's got to be teamwork. It's got to be working together to achieve those same objectives. And it's going to redefine everything. You are not likely to find anymore the lone wolf lawyer in his law office, because everything is changing with co-working. Without dramatizing it, I think it's fair to say that we're in the midst of historic change. We are participants as well as witnesses to a shift probably of greater consequence than Adam Smith's division of labor. The great difference is also its greatest threat, the power of working together, not as a process on a production line, but each in his own space, physically and mentally, but depending on the other or on others, in real time across continents to create value. That's the new age, that's the age that we're working in. So as we sit here today, we might well imagine that all that we are people who are creating a new way of working, you know, possibly just working together in spaces that are very, you know, that are defined in a different way. But the truth of the matter is that what we're actually doing is that we're actually participating in a historic change, not just in the way that we work, but in the way that we will work in the future. And that future has already arrived at our doorstep. The good thing about participants in history is that we hardly ever know until the time is past. And then we look back and say, really? So we are all part of that whole process. So I want to encourage you to say that what you're doing is an incredibly important thing. And I think that the more ideas that we're able to bring about by thinking collaboratively and working together, the greater we are, not just as individuals, but as a group. Nobody is ever going to remember individual effort anymore. It's going to be all about collaborating, about working together in unity. Thank you very much, and have a good conference.